Hi everyone. I have had several requests on seated writing tips. This video will go into detail on ways to really master the art and body mechanics science of seated writing.
This is my modded seat on my Nikola, using a wood mod to fit a custom KS18L seat. This seat is comfortable and very secure. Hundreds of miles later, it is in great shape, and what a joy to ride. Here is my take on proper seated riding. How did I ever get interested in seated riding? Initially, it was a curiosity thing when I received my custom seat. Riding the KS18L hardly ever gave me any wobbles, but when I changed to the Nikola 100 volt, wobbles would come when I would slow down. In addition, standing riding on the Nikola made my ankles sore that I really needed to master seated riding. Here I am with one of my DIY seats, trying desperately to keep my butt center on the unbalanced seat. Note how I was leaning to one side. Not only did I have to balance on the wheel, but I also had to stay balanced on the uncentered, unsecured seat. I was lucky I didn't faceplant. I look at videos of myself from a couple years back compared to now. I used to lean forward more in the beginning to accelerate. Look how I am on the KS18L. Look how different my two stances are. As I improved, I learned to just scoot forward to accelerate while having minimal lean. Which is better, long seat or bike seat? There is no comparison. Long seat allows you to have even balancing on your butt as you slide forward and back. No need to be distracted by an irregularly shaped seat such as a bike seat. Sliding forward and backward on an irregularly shaped seat while going 20 to 30 miles per hour is just another variable to contend with. This is where the acronym KISS comes along. Keep it simple, stupid. Another thing, because the bike seat is irregular, the rider would then be relegated to leaning forward to accelerate. Leaning forward will decrease your reaction time should a fall occur. The long seat just allows me to slide forward to accelerate with minimal leaning forward. This is also much easier on your back when you are upright. Your visibility is also optimal as you are more upright using the long seat. So once you get your custom seat or well-made, balanced, secure long seat, the next thing you need to do is to acclimate to the seated position on the seat. How high should the seat be? For one thing, having too high a seat will not allow you to maneuver with your knees. Basically, you will be making turns by twisting your hips, and your calves and knees will be the steering wheel. You also don't want the seat to be too low, as there will come a time when you have to rapidly stand up to gain better control of the wheel to avoid a crash or to be able to run out of crash depending on the situation. For most people, this seat should be more than enough height to allow for easy maneuverability as well as being able to easily switch to standing riding. The perfect seat height really does make a difference. I was able to get up quickly and able to make quick maneuvers to avoid a crash. At first, it will be quite intimidating and unnatural. First off, Remember that you only have a small area to work with when seated. You don't make any drastic mods on the EUC. Just have a firm, secure, long seat centered on the wheel. Nothing else. Therefore, proper leg and feet position must be optimal in order to have great control of the wheel. The key thing is to lift your heels up when feet are planted on the pedals. This will prevent you from straining your tendons and muscles of the leg. It will also relax your quadriceps, which are used in standing riding, as well as prevent you from leaning forward. How do you switch from standing riding to seated riding? From the standing position, keep your eyes on the road while switching positions. Position one hand on the seat to have an idea how far down you have to sit, as well as how far back or forward to place your butt. By having one hand on the seat, it will help to balance the shift in weight when you plant your butt on the wheel. Over time, you won't have to do that, as that shift in weight can be balanced out in how you position your knees and feet forward as you sit down. For now, just use the hand on seat to evenly distribute the weight when you sit down. How about for standing up from the seated position? Two ways to do this. You can try using your hands to slightly shift your weight back as you lift your butt up. This will allow you to keep the weight distributed evenly on the wheel. Keep doing this over and over until eventually you won't need to use your hand to evenly distribute the weight when changing from standing to seated and vice versa. When you get better, no need to use your hand for weight distribution. Basically, just plant both feet back to the pedals as you lift your butt from the seat. Just make sure you keep your eyes on the road as you do this. So what situations are best for seated riding? Number one, when the path is straight and unobstructed and there are less variables to cause a crash, seated riding is better. Number two, when the distance to travel is long. Number three, with medical conditions such as degenerative joint disease or chronic ankle or knee pain from an injury. Number four, when the rider is tired and legs and ankles are sore. Number five, when you want to go really fast and the road is clear. Streamlined and well secured on the wheel, your fast ride is quite optimized. Number six, when the wobble starts to happen on the wheel, changing to seated will make the wobbles disappear. When is standing riding better? When there are more variables that can lead to a crash, standing riding is better. For example, number one, crowds and especially with children present. Number two, grass which can cover irregularities such as holes and mounds. Number three, when there is a need to slow down, such as making a turn, quick turns are easier. Number four, when the road is very uneven and there is a high chance of a crash and a possible need to bail out. Number five, when the road is wet and slippery. Number six, when the path is tight and narrow, you want to make yourself as narrow as possible. Standing riding is better.
Well, that's it. If you like this video, I would greatly appreciate it if you click like and subscribe. About 80% of people that watch this video just move on. It would really help me out in the YouTube algorithm, and I would love to have 1,000 subscribers, hopefully by the end of this year. And don't make as many videos as I would like, as unfortunately, work keeps me away from this passion of EUCs. You won't have to worry about me flooding your inbox. So please help me out, and I will keep putting out more quality videos for you to enjoy. So ride safely, and until next time.